I think as people move work more and more workload into the cloud, they're starting to wake up to a new reality. It's not about CapEx. It's not about amortizing, assets on cement. It's about kind of operating, so operating expense, and then how do you manage that new estate? And so a lot of people are realizing they almost need a cloud economics PhD in order to operate in the cloud. And that's partly true, because each provider has different approaches to pricing, different approaches to optimization. You can pre-purchase capacity. You can do things in order to reduce your price and optimize your price, but then you have to optimize your estate. And so it's a combination of price and quantity. And from a quantity standpoint, you have to know, are your resources over-provisioned, under-provisioned? Are they lying dormant? Did you shut down some resources like a VM, all right, but then left your storage up and running? And so, there's little gotchas in the cloud that people don't necessarily understand. And it's those gotchas that will create something that we call bill shock. And so if you're not actively managing your estate day to day, eyes on glass, you may not realize, what things are costing. And at the end of the month, you may get a bill that you're surprised about because, again, a human did something they weren't supposed to do. And so, you have to create that visibility, and you have to create that knowledge to understand kind of what are the different levers that I can use in order to optimize my bill, all right, and pay as low as possible, because those levers exist, but you have to be aware.